الله أكبر والله أكبر، الله أكبر والله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله، حي على الصلاة، حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، حي على الفلاح، الله أكبر والله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا، يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، فإن كل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار، وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. Praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He's the only one worthy of praise. I seek His help, His guidance, and His forgiveness. I believe in Him and I trust Him. I seek refuge on Almighty Allah from the evil of our passions. Indeed, whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides him to al-Islam, no one can mislead him after Allah. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him astray, no one can guide him after Allah. I testify openly that there is no deity worthy of worship other than Allah Rabbil Alameen. And I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam His messenger and the seal of all the prophets. O Muslims, you must know that the best speech is the speech of Almighty Allah, which is the Quran. The best guidance is the course of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is his sunnah. The worst of all affairs is innovation and addition to the religion of Islam. Indeed, every addition to the religion of Islam will lead to hellfire. I adjure you as well as myself to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the best of your ability. Fear Allah and don't die unless you are in a state of Islam. In this khutbah, inshallah, I would like to discuss two issues. It's so amazing to find in 1 week that we have two occasion or two celebration, or they may call it a two Eid. And none of them has anything to do with us as Muslims. But you'd be surprised how many Muslims that they are part of this Eid or celebration or festival. As for the first one, which is supposed to be in the 12th of Rabi', and somebody came after Salat al-Maghrib to this mosque few nights ago, and he was shocked that almost nobody in the mosque, and he said, are you guys not celebrating the birthday of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? I said to him, we send peace and the blessing on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam every day, and we are celebrating the birthday of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam every day, and we every day think and remember the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in our salah and out of salah. Why it have to be this night only? People go sometimes by culture, not by deen. People sometimes go by what is more popular and known to many people, what you call maybe majority. And people go by whatever feeling and emotion. But none of this has to do anything with Islam. Because the problem with many, the problem of many Muslims, they believe in deen, which they did not realize the meaning of this deen. The deen that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمُ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا, and pleased with Islam to be a way of life for you, call Islam. And Islam means a total submission, a total surrender to your desire, to your culture, to what the people doing? No. Islam means a total submission and surrender to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, this is what is supposed to go. Whatever the people believe, those people who believe in Islam, they have to understand Islam means surrender to the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, do or don't. Other than this, if Muslims could not even understand the meaning and the title of their deen, how are you expecting them to be united? How are you expecting them to be a ummah? How are you expecting them to have victory? How are you expecting them to have salvation? How are you expecting them to be able to solve their problems, economic problems, political problems, all kind of problems? Even a name, you could not realize it. You don't live up to the name, this is a serious problem. My question to any Muslim, a scholar or a learned person or a student of knowledge, and pay attention, show me one single verse in Quran or one single hadith in all the saying and the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that he ordered us or at least recommended for us to celebrate his birthday. This is all what I want. If he showed to me, I'll be the first one to celebrate. I'll be the first one to promote it. But if not, do you know what you're doing? By doing something that is not in the book of Allah, neither it is in the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you are belying Allah, you are blind the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell us about the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, harisun alaykum bil mu'minina raufur rahim, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is over concerned, over protected for you. He loves you so much. He cared for you so much. The Quran told us this. But my question, if Allah telling us that the Prophet cared for us, why the Prophet did not tell us about such occasion or festival or celebration that will bring us closer to Allah? Why? When you're doing this, you're saying that it is part of the deen or is not part of the deen? If it's part of the deen, where is it? So now you're saying that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he did not deliver the message. He gave some of the message, but he did not give it completely. That means you're saying the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam betrayed the message. Why the Prophet did not tell us? Why he didn't tell us about celebrating his birthday? If it's there, show it to me which Quran, which verse in the Quran, which surah in the Quran. If it's not there in hadith, tell me which hadith. So we can be on the same page. But if not, you are belying Allah that he said, Al-yawma akmaltu lakum deenakum. وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمْ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا. Today, I have perfected the deen for you. I completed the religion for you. I'm pleased with Islam to be a way of life for you. How can Allah say the Quran and the deen of Islam is complete and this thing about celebration is not there? It's a serious matter to belie Allah. Allah say, I completed. Your action saying, no, Allah, you did not complete the deen. Because one thing is missing there. The celebration of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam birthday. Allah say, I completed. But your action say, no, Allah, you did not. Where do you stand? When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam telling you, that I didn't leave, ma taraktu min shay'in, يقربكم إلى الله إلا وقد أمرتكم به أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. I did not neglect or leave anything which bring you closer to Allah without ordering you about it. So where is it? Where is the order of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم? And do you know what? You're cursing all the Sahaba of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. How? Because he's saying Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, he didn't love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Umar, Ali, Uthman, all the thousands and thousands of the Sahaba, they don't care about the Prophet, they don't love the Prophet. Can you tell me where this tradition or this information, those people who give their love, their blood, their money for Allah and his messenger, was too much for them to celebrate one night, and we could not find any information in the whole collection of Islam? Maybe something wrong with us. Maybe something wrong, not with us, with those people who transmitted this deed to us. Because somebody maybe claimed, yes, was there, but it's not there now. Where is it? Also, now you're saying that Bukhari and Imam Malik, Shafi'i, and Ibn Taymiyyah, all those scholars and all these great people of Islam, they came about this part and they removed it as a result of this. Because you're claiming it's there, but you could not show it. So is there or not there? Allah ordered or he didn't order? Allah is telling us, وَمَا أَتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا. Whatever the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gives you, that take. Act upon it. And whatever he forbade you, stay away from it. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had forbade us from inventing in the deen of Allah, fabricating and adding things to the deen of Allah. Any foreigner statement or a sentence of any ibadah, if it's not in Quran or hadith, not understood by the Sahaba, could not be part of the deen. And he said, وَإِيَّاكُمْ وَمُحْدَثَاتِ الْأُمُورِ. Be aware of every invented matter, new things. Not the time of the Sahaba, not the time of the Tabi'een, not the time of the Tabi'een, we heard about this so-called celebration. Celebration, an Eid, and you may call the term feast, it's part of the deen. As a result of this, he found it had been designed by Allah, where and when and how. This is the Prophet ﷺ telling us, and by his action, that to pray Eid outside. So, this is the Prophet ﷺ didn't make adhan for Salat al-Eid. So everything he clarified to us. He's Amin, trustworthy. Did he tell us about the takbir, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah? Did he tell us about the 2 days that we're supposed to celebrate? Why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? So that means this is part of our deen, our ibadah, our way of getting closer to Allah. As a result of this, it's been explained by Allah, explained by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what you're supposed to do, what you are not supposed to do. Why we have to add to the deen? One of the great scholars, if I'm not mistaken, Imam Malik rahmatullah alayh, is saying what the meaning is, من أحدث من استحسن في الدين فقد شرع ومن شرع فقد اتهم محمدا بأنه خان الرسالة. Whosoever invent in the deen of Allah, bring something new, is not in the book of the law, is not in the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He brings something new. Say, brother, this is good. We get together, we're going to eat food, we're going to say sallallahu ala Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, chant and make an al-madiyah and make all these lights, and to you is something good. So this is tihsan, it's hasan, it's good. Let's introduce it to the people. Who said, do this, whosoever do this, he made legislation in the deen. And whosoever make legislation in the deen, he's saying by his action, Muhammad had betrayed the message. And if any Muslim believes that the Prophet ﷺ betrayed the message, he will be out of Islam. If this is part of your aqeedah, you could not be a Muslim even if you pray day and night. Something was good, but the Prophet didn't tell us about it. So my dear respected brothers and sisters, there is no room in Islam for innovation, addition. Everything Allah say, أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ. I completed the religion. Allah say, I completed. But you saying to Allah, no Allah, you didn't complete it. As a result of this Allah, you didn't tell us about celebrating the birthday of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's not a matter of celebration or not celebration. Eating rice, butting or whatever that you're doing, is a matter of your heart is not submitting to Allah. فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ حَتَّى يُحَكِّمُوكَ فِي مَا شَجَرَ بَيْنَهُمْ ثُمَّ لَا يَجِدُوا فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ حَرَجًا مِمَّا قَضَيْتْ وَيُسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. Allah is swearing, not me and you. We may swear to each other and sometimes even we lie. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is swearing. And swearing by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, by thy Lord of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah swearing to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by himself. Those people could not be true believers until they make you Muhammad a judge between them in any matter. And when they found the result, they have a full submission and they did not have any ill feeling or ifs and buts in their hearts. You have to submit inward and outward to the order of Allah and the order of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Otherwise, you be out of the iman and the deen of Allah. وَيُسَلِّمُ تَسْلِيمًا. You could not have any more, any demur in your heart. You could not have any ifs and buts in your heart about the order of Allah. Who brought this mawlid and who introduced it? Now this is not my issue. Whosoever did it, this is not my business. How everybody doing it in every country, even the sheikh of such an institution attended, and the president of such a country, they will do it, and all these things. What the people doing doesn't constitute what is sunnah and what is bid'ah. What is the people is doing does not tell you what is Islam and what is not Islam. What's Islam and what's not Islam? What Allah said was the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam had said or did or approved. Other than this, no. Some people, they confuse the Muslims and they play games on them. And they go to try to take one from the east, one from the south, one from the north, and get a verse from here and hadith from here. Say, did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say about Yahya? As-salamu alayya yawma wulidtu wa yawma amutu wa yawma uba'athu hayya? Yes, it's verse in the Quran. What does this have to do with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? And may peace be upon me the day that I was born, and the day that I shall die, and the day that Allah will resurrected me. So what does this mean? So here Allah is saying salam with the Prophet on the day that he was born. So now you see, the scholar, they say this Quran is hammal. That means you can carry out in a way to support whatever things that you want introduce it to the people. Do we have a clear, okay, Allah is talking about Yahya. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam been asked about the fasting of Monday. He said, ذَلِكَ يَوْمٌ وُلِدْتُ فِيهِ وَذَلِكَ يَوْمٌ بُعِثْتُ فِيهِ أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم قال أنزل علي فيه. Why, O Prophet of Allah, fast Monday? He said, because this is the day which I was born, and this is the day that I received the mission, the Islam. Okay, it's fine. You really want to celebrate the birthday of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam according to the Sunnah, not according to the bid'ah. So why you don't fast every Monday? Oh, no, no, this is too much. Every week, let's try to find something, understand, once a year, and get you understand, big pot and rice pudding and gather the people, jump up and down, and after this we're singing, and men and women, or whatever it is, and now we already took care of business. We don't have time for the Prophet, because your love for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is not there. Nevertheless, I end this part of the khutbah with the statement of Allah, which is a scholar, they say this is a verse of a challenge. What is the challenge? قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهِ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. Say, if you really love Allah, so follow me. So follow me. Allah will love you and forgive for you your sins. The true mahabba, the true love for the Prophet of Allah, that you follow the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in what he did, what he said, how he acted in everything. But for you to make your own recipe of the love, now you are lying in your love. You don't love the Prophet. You are faking in your love. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the true love to Islam, Ameen. The true love to the deen of Allah, Ameen. The true love to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, wa usalli wa usallimu ala mab'uthi rahmatan lil alameen. As I say, it's so amazing. In 1 week, he found two occasions, and they celebrated by some Muslims, or majority of the Muslims, but none of them have anything to do with Islam. One was the birthday of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the second one, it happened in this week, or maybe supposed to be today, that some Muslims, and I'm sorry, to say that some Muslims they doing, they celebrating Christmas. Yes, I heard you. Some of you say Astaghfirullah, Israel. I went to somebody's office or shop or whatever you want. I found a Christmas tree inside the office or the shop or whatever you call, longer and higher than me. I went to somebody's office and they have a Christmas party. I'm talking about Muslims. You can pass by some neighbor's hood and you will see the lights and the Christmas tree and the lights on the windows, blue and red and green lights. What is going on? The shock yesterday that I was looking to a Islamic country on YouTube, Islamic country, and the sheikh, and they have delegation from the mosque in the church, because you know we have 7-8 hours different between us and overseas, so they already have it in YouTube, and I saw it yesterday. They attended in the church, and some of them, they stood up to light the candle. They participated in a munkar. You know what's Christmas? This is the day of birthday of Jesus, alayhi salam, Isa. That means this is the day that the Rabb or their God was born. How God can born? Your aqidah is say, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ اللَّهُ الصَّمَدُ لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ. So when you're supporting such a thing, you are saying he's yalid or he is yulad. But it say lam, he was not born. Neither he gave birth. He's not the father of anyone. Neither he is the son of anyone. Your action is totally different from what you say to be in your heart. How this can be happening? But we've been drafted by being part of what is going on, being in the melting pot. My brothers and sisters, I want to tell you one thing. There is no melting pot. The melting pot, this is a wrong expression. We may say it, we are a solid ball. The melting pot, when you bought everything, you don't know what it is. You don't know if it's a chicken or the soup or not. You don't know what it is. It's everything is melted, became one thing. But the salad bowl, you still see the pieces of tomatoes and the pieces of lettuce and the pieces of cucumbers. It's this distinguish each other, and you can even get the taste of each other. Say, how you want to be in America and you are not going to celebrate Christmas? You try to tell me I did something goof that I say Merry Christmas? They're trying to change it now. I found one organization sending card on the internet, and now to try to avoid this, say Happy Holiday or Holiday, whatever. Happy Holiday. Which holiday? Which holiday are you talking about? The birthday of your God? Do you believe in this? So you say to somebody, congratulations to your belief. You say to somebody, what you're doing is good. Where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَشْهَدُونَ الزُّورِ وَإِذَا مَرُّوا بِاللَّهُ مَرُّوا كِرَامًا. Those who are not attend or be part of falsehood. Is this not falsehood? The whole deen of Islam about Tawheed, about La ilaha illallah. How you can be a Muslim and you imitated non-Muslim? And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam telling you, مَنْ تَشَبَّهَ بِقَوْمٍ فَهُوَ مِنْهُمْ أَوْ كَمَا قَالَ sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Whosoever imitates a people, he became one of them. He'll be resurrected with them. You want to be resurrected as a Jew, as a Christian? We teach aqidah. We are not teaching hatred. The hatred comes from them and they do it publicly. right? And I'm sure most of you already heard about this professor, okay? Liberty University or whatever, that he was telling the students about thousands of thousands. Each one of you have to have a permit. You have to have a gun. And I wish one of them come. I'm teaching these Muslims a lesson. We don't preach hate. We are not telling you bother people in their churches. We don't tell you go and step on somebody's foot. Islamists say, "Ud'u ila sabili rabbika bil hikmah wal maw'idhat al hasana." But it's not maw'idha hasana. Invite them all to the way of your Lord by giving them a Christmas card or sitting eating with them or being part of them. This is not a da'wah. This is support of their da'wah. This, it shows love and sympathy with them for doing this. Doesn't matter what the people God classify you in America, this doesn't matter. You are supposed to be classified by Allah, by His angels, by the believers, that you be in the company of the Muslims, the company of the believers. You could not be in a mess like this because we don't believe in it. You have a whole surah called Surah Al-Kafirun. Do you believe in the surah? قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا الْكَافِرُونَ لَا أَعْبُدُ مَا تَعْبُدُونَ. Do you believe in the surah? So why you taking in part of their celebration? This is a form of ibadah. If you say Subhanallah, this is a form of ibadah. If you prostrate, this is a form of ibadah. If you raise your hand to make dua, this is a form of ibadah. From A to Z, Islam is nothing but ibadah. Ibadah by your limbs, ibadah by your heart, ibadah by your intention, everything, even your feeling. ثَلَاثٌ مَنْ كُنَّ فِيهِ وَجَدَ بِهِنَّ حَلَوَةِ الْإِيمَانِ. Three characteristics, anyone possesses them, he will get the sweetness of faith. That Allah and His Messenger will be dearer to him than anybody else. Let Allah be your best friend. Let Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be your best friend. And you try to please Him more than pleasing your boss in the job, or the party that you're in, or the teams that you play with them. All what we're saying, any form of ibadah that people doing it, we could not do it. Even that is the hair, appearance, everything. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to his people, to the Sahaba, to dye their hair. فَإِنَّ الْيَهُودَ لَا يَسْبِغُونَ. That because the Jews, they did not change the color of their beard or their hair, so you make henna. You dyed your hair. Subhanallah. He's concerned about the color of your hair. If you have a gray hair, you old man, I'm already old for this, but it's sick. Why? To have to be distinguished. Not to be look like them in any shape or form or anyway. My brothers and sisters, it's time for us to learn our deen. It's time for us to live our deen. Doesn't matter. Whatever hardship you're going to be facing, you are not better than the Prophet, neither you are better than the Sahaba. They try to practice their deen and they have a hardship. They have a hardship. So you think, you understand, you won't be living in America and you are not going to have a hardship. They're going to single you out. And they're going to say it in public. And Allah telling you in Quran, وَمَا تُخْفِي صُدُورُهُمْ أَكْبَرٌ. And what they hide in their hearts is much greater than what they say. But some of them, they dare to say it. And some of them, they stood to say it. Wallahi, by Allah, I don't mind that this guy, he says that, put the Muslim out, or don't let them come in anymore, for him to be the president. You know what? Because this is the time you go to try to have unity among yourself. This is the time you go to start to care for each other. This is the time you go to start to practice your deen. We are so spoiled to such a degree, we're doing anything that we want, doesn't matter. You look like a Jew or a Christian, it doesn't look, what, this is not. It's time for us to stand for what we believe. Yes, this not your country, that means you are not raised here, but we are not stepping in anybody's toes. We worship, we claim what we worship, we claim our belief, without stepping in anybody's toes. They said, we don't carry guns, we don't go and stand and invade the church, we don't do any of these things. We don't terrorize people, we don't not scare people, but we have to exist. And thank you, America, after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for Allah making a way that we can be in America. So enjoy the peace. And enjoy also that you can practice your deen. The problem is not America. The problem is me and you. The problem is not America. You can look to France when they forbid women to have the hijab or to enter the university with hijab. Even Islamic countries, they did this. But you're living in America. They are not stopping you to put hijab on. But they found most of, a lot of sisters, they taken their hijab off. Not because somebody make a threat. No, because you don't feel comfortable. So when we going to learn that we stand for our deen and practice our deen and hold fast to our deen? You did not read the hadith. The Prophet said there will come time that a person who holds into his deen will be like a person who holding a piece of charcoal, a fire in his hand. We're enjoying everything. You don't even feel a pinch or been bit by ant or mosquito. We enjoy everything. And it's not going to work like this. Like a baby. The mother keep breastfeeding him. He will be 5 and 6 years old and he's still breastfeeding. Why? Because the mother did not show him that it's time to stop. And I know about stories like this. Back home village, how kids are so spoiled, 5 years old, still his mother giving him, breastfeeding him. So we enjoying all the things here and relaxing and enjoying everything. Nobody imposes in you to send a Christmas card. Nobody asks you that you have to take your headpiece off. No one asks you to shave your beard. Nobody asks you to deal with usury. Nobody asks you to sell khamr and khanzir in your convenience store. We choose to do it. We do it with our own choice. And sooner or later, you'll be selling marijuana. And Allah knows best, what else you're going to be selling? It's our own choice. We're doing it because the country gives us a lot of freedom. And we are misusing. And we think that everything is flourish and everything is bright and everything is good. It's time to read the surah and to understand what the surah says. لا أعبد ما تعبدون ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد. So what is this? Is there a repetition in the surah? 4 verses is saying لا أعبد ما تعبدون ولا أنتم عابدون ولا أنا عابد ما عبدتم ولا أنتم عابدون. It's two things. One, that I don't worship whom you worship. Neither you worship the one that I worship. Nor I worship the way you worship, nor you worship the way I worship. So one related to the Creator, and one say about the way how you go to the Creator. So we did not have the same God. We don't have the same God. Neither we worship in the same methodology. If you don't understand this, you don't understand Surah Al-Kafirun, and it's time for you to read it, to understand it, and lift it. Allah did not give us Quran so we can be blah, 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 like this. No. Allah said, to reflect on its verses, to live it. How was the Prophet? كان خلقه القرآن. How was the Prophet? He was a Quran. That his behavior, his mannerism was the Quran. In the mosque, in the street, with his family, in the business, in the war, out of the war, khuluquhu al-Quran. This is the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Let's try to celebrate the Prophet's birthday every day, not once a year. How? Learn his sunnah, revive his sunnah, and teach others about the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this is the real love, not the fake love. I beg Allah's forgiveness for me and you and all the Muslims. Amen. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings the Muslim ummah back to their religion. Amen. The true religion which is free from all kind of lies and innovation. Wa akhiru da'wana and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Hayyal as-salam. قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر والله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استووا اعتدلوا تراسوا استريت ذا لاين بليز موف فورورد أخي موف فورورد استريت ذا لاين بليز استووا استووا اعتدلوا الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين ألم نشرح لك صدرك ووضعنا عنك وزرك الذي أنقض ظهرك ورفعنا لك ذكرك فإن مع العسر يسرا إن مع العسر يسرا فإذا فرغت فانصب وإلى ربك فارغب الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين قل يا أيها الكافرون لا أعبد ما تعبدون ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد ولا أنا عابد ما عبدتم ولا أنتم ما أعبد لكم دينكم ولي دين. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.